Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is going to be a bit of a different video just because I wanted to show you guys how you can make a shit ton of money from basically level 5 because when you unlock the outdoor grow seeds in this game, you're only about level 5, I think. So it's really going to depend on how much money you have to buy the seeds and to buy water effectively. But if you can buy, say, 100 seeds, you're going to be flipping that pretty effectively, you know, to get a shit ton of money, which is going to allow you to basically just, you know, have the easiest time possible. The only thing with this tutorial is it takes a little while just for the seeds to grow, so I really recommend investing in, say, couches, or even what I do is I get the beds, but you can only I only recommend buying like a few of the double beds, because if you buy too many, well, one, you're not going to have an apartment big enough to put all the beds in. But the wait timer only goes up to 25. So when I had one of my big warehouses, and I had that, I literally have houses around the map that I call wait houses, where literally I just go in there just to wait, so for my seeds to grow. So the first thing you want to go, hello, the first thing you want to gonna do is, once you unlock him, is to speak and get a tutorial set up, well, a meeting set up with Barney Roman. He's going to be the guy to sell you the seeds. Now, as you can see here, I've got quite a bit of money. This is just money from gangs that I, you know, from the poker, but you don't need to worry about that. But you can flip pretty much with like 5k, you can get quite a lot. So I'll quickly show you real quick. Is so you're only going to have the outdoor seeds unlocked, and these are technically the only ones that I recommend. Now, the one that I recommend the most is Skyscraper. That's going to give you your most marijuana grow, basically. So as you can see, if I come here with 5,000, I can afford quite comfortably 100. So that's a good idea. I'm not gonna buy it because I've already pre-recorded this, but yeah, you can quite easily buy, you know, 100 seeds for 3,500. And then what you wanna gonna do is you're gonna wanna come to any grocery store. Chances are it's gonna be the gas station, and you're gonna wanna buy quite a few water bottles. So the best thing about this as well is when you've just spoken to Barney, marijuana seeds aren't actually detectable by police, so because they're not considered a drug for some reason. But you can quite happily just go through checkpoints with all your seeds on you, and nothing bad's going to happen. So just remember that. So that's going to cut down some time of you throwing the bags over the walls and stuff. So yeah, you'd want to go to the gas station and pick up literally as many bottles of water as you can, because it's going to be very time consuming, especially if your hideout isn't close enough to one of the grow sites. Running back and forth constantly, it's going to be very, very annoying. So I really recommend filling up as much water as you possibly can. And also that water is going to make you very heavy as well. So I do recommend, you know, large bags, but just get a hideout that is going to be very close to where you're going to be either drying the weed or selling the weed. So what I've done is I've done it at a few grow sites. Now this one, stink building floor, this is okay if you're doing like say 50 plants, maybe even a little bit more. But as you start to get closer to this building, by the end of the grow cycle, police start to find the marijuana that's being grown. So you need to be hot on the heels, and occasionally a police patrol, like car stop thing, will be on this street here. So you really need to be careful with this one, because they can catch you with a bag full of weed as you're bringing them in. So you need to be really careful at this grow site. So it's not the best one. The best one that I found is, funnily enough, in a different YouTube video. I used to grow my weed way out over here, but since they've added this camp here, I've stopped doing that, and I've actually been growing them here. Now this is in another video, but I will show you this as well. There is a little bit where you can't plant them, But as long as you get this hideout, you should be all good. This hideout is going to be probably your weight house as well. So I do recommend getting some furniture for it. But basically, all of this area you can grow to your heart's content. And there's a little bit right here where these rocks are that you can't plant the seeds. But as long as you plant them in rows, so what I do, as you can see in the video coming up soon, maybe even now, is that I plant them in rows, so it's really easy to water them. Now you can, I mean in the video, about 100 seeds will take you up to about, say around here, do you know what I mean? But honestly, you can do quite a lot more, do you know what I mean? So it's really, really useful. And then let's I think skip to the bit where I watered them and everything, and get to it. Alright, now that you've grown and dried your weed, you will need the psychedelic gang unlocked. They come in this building right here, and it's a little bit of a hard thing to find the candles, but once you've got them, it's absolutely brilliant because you can make as much money as you need very, very quickly, as long as you keep growing the marijuana. So you're going to come in here, and you're going to turn just round to this guy, and now John, if you speak to him and you sell all your weed to him, he's going to give you a very discounted price. I think it's like $5-6 a gram, so it's not very that much if you're thinking about flipping it to you know, the public. But definitely if you're growing huge amounts like over here, it's still a lot of payout, so it is very worthwhile doing, especially early on once you've just unlocked them. So keep growing that weed, make sure you've got a fuck ton dried and ready to go to John as soon as you unlock the gang, because it is absolutely incredible. And effectively, all the money that I get from growing, I just whack into the guy's name, but it's the person that launders your money, and you go to one of the launder hideouts, and you start laundering the money there, like knocking on the door, say for this building here, and basically all the money I make from growing, it goes on this, and effectively you make so much, that it just makes, you know, everything so much easier, because you can just buy all the hideouts and then grow from more places, or even have setups, say going through, you know, the checkpoints, you just run through them and just go straight into a hideout, you know what I mean, and when you're smuggling stuff over, because your hideouts are so close. But I can just show you, I've just done a grow quite a while ago, and you log into your bank account, and suddenly, you know, once you start investing in this stuff, you just have loads of disposable income, so it's really, really nice to do. So yeah, highly recommend growing, especially skyscraper. Thank you guys for watching, and see you later. Bye.